In this example, we've got the pivot table and there's lots of data. We just want to summarize it nicely by year. So we want the years to go across here so we can create some sparklines. What we can do is make use of GETPIVOTDATA. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create one. Now instead of typing it, where it's very hard, rather just say equals, and we can see January 2013 for the grand total is that one. You'll see it creates its own little formula. Now that I've created the first one, I can rework this formula. So you can see the first, it says the data field is file number, I'm happy with that. Pivot table starts at A3, I'm happy with that. Issue date, you'll see it says a 1. Because we're in January, Excel notices that January actually is month 1, hence I've created some numbers here. Instead of looking at a typed in 1, I wanted to look at that cell there. I'm going to put my dollar signs on the H, because when I copied across, I needed always to be looking at those numbers. Then we've got the years, and at the moment it was typed in 2013, but I'm going to say rather look at whatever's in that cell. And this one I'm going to put the dollar signs on so that the row stays the same. When I say OK, I get the same number. But now when I copy it down, you'll see it goes 47, 69, etc. When I copy it across, 1208, which is 1208. 2016 is 192, 2016 is 192. So we've now taken the pivot table and reworked in a format that we want, and perhaps now we can add some sparklines so we can see what the trend is in the months. Maybe copy those down. We can now get a sense of what the trend is annually in January, February, etc.